Have you ever wondered how those massive skyscrapers, concrete structures, houses, and other buildings are erected? From a direct point of view, the first material that comes to mind is concrete. However, hidden beneath the concrete is the unsung hero of construction, rebar, which helps these buildings stay sturdy. Let's dive into the fascinating process of how these steel rods that provide durability and strength to every concrete structure are made. History of rebar. Historically, a French engineer named Henri Gautier patented a design of using mesh steel to reinforce concrete. This was a significant addition to the use of concrete for construction, and later into the 19th and 20th centuries, the reinforced steel bars with different patterns were introduced. The construction industry saw a great increase after World War II, and the demand for rebar also significantly increased. So, what exactly is rebar, and how is it made? What is rebar? Short for reinforcement bar, rebar is a long metal bar which is usually used to make a structural map of the desired structure over which the concrete is poured. These metal rods provide the required tensile strength to keep the building upright and prevent any catastrophic damage to the structure. Rebar is usually made of high-quality steel since steel and concrete share similar thermal expansion properties, resulting in reduced temperature change problems. The main purpose of rebar is to provide extra strength to the concrete structure, since it can bear shearing loads, torsion, bending, and tensile. Concrete alone is not structurally strong enough to withhold these massive loads. How is rebar made? As we already know, rebar is usually made of steel. But where does this steel come from? Interestingly enough, scrap and recycled steel is massively used to make rebar rods. Steel from old scrap cars, electronic appliances such as ovens and fridges, and even old industrial machinery are melted down in special electric arc furnaces, which can reach temperatures over 1,800 degrees Fahrenheit. Hot rolling process. Once the steel is melted down, it is stored in the form of billets to cool down and be used later to make long metal rods with the help of specialized tools and machines. When cooled, they are reheated to a specific temperature, which is usually just below its melting point, and special extrusion tools are used to neck down the steel billets into smaller circular rods, until the required diameters of the rebar rods are achieved. The hot rebar rods are also passed through a series of rollers to give them the desired shape and diameters. This process is known as hot rolling. The cold working process. Our rebar is now made, but is it ready to use? Not quite yet. Rebar rods cannot be used to their full capacity unless the specific rib designs are made on it. A special process known as cold working is used to deform the smooth rebar rods at room temperature. Once the rebar rod is heated and given a cylindrical shape in the desired diameter, it is passed through a series of dies that have different patterns embossed on them. The dies imprint the patterns onto the piping hot rebar rods, providing them the necessary strength to bond with the surrounding concrete. Quenching. After the cold working procedure is complete, the rods are dipped into cold water or kept in cold, airy rooms to quickly cool down. This is known as quenching. Quenching ensures that the steel is hardened completely and is ready to be used for construction purposes. Cutting the rebar rods. The last and final stage in the rebar making process is to cut the cooled down rebar rods into desired lengths. For cutting, special equipment such as hydraulic cutters and electric cutters are used. Rebar rods are measured and then marked at the desired cutting point, usually with chalk. After marking, the available cutting equipment such as manual cutters, hydraulic cutters, or electrical cutters are used to cut the rods into required lengths. Once the rebar is cut, its edges are usually very sharp and dangerous to handle. To prevent injuries, a process called deburring is used to make the edges of these steel rods smooth. Once the rebar rods are made, bundles are made and tied together using a strong steel wire. Then they are weighed by an industrial weighing machine and kept aside for storage and shipping. How does rebar work? Rebar rods are used to make a grid-patterned map of the building structure, and later, concrete is poured over it. The tensile strength of steel along with the compressive strength of concrete bonds together to give an extra structural integrity and prevents cracking, fractures, bending, and the collapsing of walls, pillars, and roofs. Rebar rods are placed in parallel or perpendicular to each other, ensuring that the tensile forces are withstood from all directions and the weight of the concrete structure is distributed equally. Different structures have different requirements for structural integrity. Therefore, sometimes the straight-ribbed rebar rods are enough. However, to provide more strengths, Some engineers also bend the ends of rebar to act as a hook or anchor, resulting in added strength. Why is rebar important? Concrete itself is a material that provides excellent compression strength, but lacks severely in terms of tensile and torsional strength. Rebar, since made of hardened steel, provides excellent tensile and torsional strength. The limitations which concrete has are fulfilled by rebar, enabling the concrete structure to withhold heavy loads without succumbing to cracks and fractures. To prevent such damage which could result in heavy loss, rebar is used. Types of rebar. It is a common misconception that rebar is a single product. Rebar has different types, and these are determined by the type of steel used to make these rebar rods. Some common types of rebar include carbon steel rebar. This is the most common type of rebar, and it is usually used for construction of houses, buildings, and plazas. Carbon steel rebar can also be welded, and therefore becomes a more suitable option for low-strength buildings. Stainless steel rebar. Stainless steel rebar is used where corrosion is an issue. To prevent rusting of rebar, stainless steel is used to make the rebar rods. However, this is a more costly option, and therefore it is not used very commonly. Epoxy-coated rebar. Epoxy coating is usually done to provide corrosion prevention at a budget. However, the coating is prone to damage since it is delicate. European rebar. European rebar is the least common type of rebar used, as it is made of a softer metal, manganese. These rebars bend easier than steel and therefore are not reliable. Where is rebar used? Almost all concrete structures, be it houses, buildings, skyscrapers, bridges, or parking ramps, use reinforced steel bars to provide extra structural integrity. It is also used in the columns and beams of high-rise buildings, plazas, and malls. Furthermore, the foundations of buildings also require large quantities of rebar to be used to reinforce the concrete, enabling the foundation to settle easily and to resist any cracks that may cause damage to the building. If you ever come across a large bridge, you may have noticed large cylindrical or rectangular pillars underneath. These pillars are what hold the complete weight of the bridge and the cars, trucks, and other vehicles which pass over it. Rebar and reinforced concrete are the main components which have the tensile strength to uphold such massive structures. Different grades of rebar. Factories and steel mills usually make rebars of different grades, and each grade depicts the yield strength of the rebar. Usually, grade 40 is the lowest strength rebar, and has a minimum yield strength of around 40,000 pounds per square inch. The highest available grade is grade 100, with a minimum yield strength of 100,000 psi. Grade 40 rebar is usually used in buildings which do not have heavy loads, whereas grade 100 rebar is used in massive skyscrapers, buildings, and other structures which have specific requirements such as earthquake resistance. Apart from grade 40 and grade 100, several other grades of rebar such as grade 65, 75, and 80 are also made. Each grade depicts the minimum yield strength, and contractors, engineers, and builders can calculate the required grade of rebar to be used depending on the design and desired characteristics of the structure to be erected. Did you enjoy watching the process of how reinforced steel bars are made? Let us know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed today's video, then make sure to leave us a thumbs up. And do not forget to subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon to always be updated with the most exciting content as soon as it's uploaded. Thanks for watching. See you again soon in another video.